And now, it's time for Levack and Gaz to answer the question, why?
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 You know, for a show based in the communication industry, we can't even talk to each other in the same room.
Well, we start off with this. There's a lot of miscommunication going on here at 104.5 The Team, and we have to figure out why. Why, Levack, have you uncovered the blacklist on the team Twitter?
So
happened here?
So my buddy EJ, who he's a fellow Raiders fan. He's obnoxious, don't get me wrong, but he's proud of that fact, so I'm not hurting his feelings. So he photoshopped a picture of you and I on Will Ferrell, and I can't remember her name.
John O'Reilly? Sherry O'Terry.
Sherry O'Terry from the Saturday Live days as the cheerleader slash host or whatever. And he went to tweet it on the team page, and he was blocked. So I'm like, who the heck? Why would you block him? So I go in and look at the list of the blocked people, and I don't know who's blocking people, but it's like the most ridiculous list ever. And I figure it's got to be Woods.
No,
Woods on a 8:30 a.m. on a Sunday, half in the bag after watching soccer, going, I'll see some Schefter to talk about the Giants. You know, like,
blocked.
Blocked. You're all blocked.
Take that, Liverpool fans. Blocked. Fess up to the crime. No, are you blocking people?
No, Shefty was on the list. Why would I block
Shefty? Somebody blocked Shefty. Some local media people. All
That's
blocked.
So funny, though.
So I went through and I unblocked. I'm unblocking everyone.
Unblocked. Uh-oh. Brother,
clean slate.
Westworld, baby. Look out. Whole new dimension out there we're doing here.
Some of the names, though, are pretty funny.
Imagine
some of the websites clearly were just to mess with us, so they stayed blocked. If you're a real person, I unblocked you.
Can you imagine the local media people who are sitting back thinking, ooh, was I on the block list? Was it me? Was I blocked? Here are all these people, the Mighty 1-3, CBS 6-1-0. But again, you didn't do it. No. Levack, you definitely didn't do it.
I didn't know how to do it.
I definitely didn't do it. So we got to figure out. That's a new mystery here.
Figured it out long enough just to unblock people.
Who else has the account?
Why were these people blocked? We will get to that mystery. Also, maybe
I know. Yeah. I feel like I know. I can't because they don't work here anymore. I think I know who it was.
All right. I have an idea who it is now, too, with that look. And now Woods figured it out, too.
Spencer.
Red Sox and Yankees may play in London in 2019. Levack, why?
Because Major League Baseball proves yet again that they just don't get it sometimes. That's why. You don't take two games that are going to sell out that could decide a division. I mean, even though I feel like this benefits the Yankees because you're going to take two games out of Fenway, it doesn't really benefit them because you're still going to travel halfway around the world to play them.
Right.
But I just, if I'm the Red Sox, I'm looking at you going, no, you can't have two of my games against the Yankees. Two games that I'm going to sell tickets at like 20% markup and sell them all? Forget you, no.
This is happening because it's Major League Baseball and they think Red Sox, Yankees, how can we spice it up a bit? We want more ratings. We want people to talk about it all week long. The best way to do it? Any PR is good PR. Move it to London. No, it's Red Sox, Yankees. You don't have to do much to make it successful and have people care.
Right. It's like, I've got cake. You win. Don't put whipped cream
on it and everything. Right.
I don't have to eat it on top of a roof to enjoy it. It's just cake. I like it. It's good.
Louisville Cardinal basketball coach Dave Padgett has been fired. Why?
Well, they sucked. Because, you know, what's going to be the absolute fallout, you think, when it's all said and done? How many scholarships are gone? How many whatever? Because, I mean, you're still Louisville. Like, if you were a top-name coach, wouldn't you, all right, look, give me a 10-year deal so that I can live through whatever sanctions are out there because I want to coach Louisville?
My first reaction, too, was something like that. No, not as bad as Penn State, but going through the probation and everything else involved in it, yeah, it might be someone who needs a long-term contract to have success, but hearing Padgett, okay.
What about Tubby?
Tubby Smith would actually be a really good hire. Knows the area, won a championship at Kentucky. I think Louisville fans would at least embrace him, although he coached a rival before. The issue with Padgett, fair or unfair as it is, he was on Pitino's staff for 3 seasons. Okay. He played under Rick Pitino, so it's now our producer Matt Woods' theory. If someone else you know or someone you're related to is committed a crime, you're now going to jail. The old Archie Miller, Sean Miller theory.
Right. Miller Lite. Woods wants them all investigated.
Reggie Miller.
After what happened to Arizona, he wants them all. Yeah, Reggie Miller, top of the list.
Woods just started a lock them up chant in the producer room by himself. Anyways, Dave Padgett, yeah, I feel like it's something's going to come out about him, and I like the idea you had there. Long-term contract for next head coach.
Yep.
Saquon Barkley did not work out at his own pro day at Penn State. Why?
I wish he had, if I'm being perfectly honest, I wish he had, but when you've already aced the test, you know what I mean? Like when you do the AP class in high school, and hey, if you average a 95 or better, you don't have to take the final. You don't take the final as a victory lap. He already aced the test. He beat everyone of substance at the combine. He's going to be a top five pick. What's the point?
You did say, though, you wish he would have worked out at his own pro day. Is that because you just want to see how much better his numbers could have been? Or you feel bad for the NFL scouts who showed up and you're like, I'm not here for anybody else but Barkley. Like, I wasted my time going to Happy Valley. I don't know if that's why. Yeah, it's kind of what you said. Why do it? All you're doing is opening yourself up for criticism.
Can you imagine if he did it? Imagine if he beat everything. Because in your own environment, you're going to be better. I mean, I don't know if you can be better than what he did, but can you imagine if he ran like a 4.38 instead of a 4.4? If he caught some crazy passes, because I see him in the Penn State blue and white, and I think of those passes where he's like grabbing the ball out of the air and everything.
This is going to seem like a silly question, but why is that? Like, the turf is the same. The equipment's the same. Is it the nice stopwatches? Like, do you have an assistant coach holding your stopwatch, giving you that extra half second?
It could be that. It could be, like, it's funny, too, because I never realized how detrimental the combine really is. So when you train for the combine, you stop training for football. They teach you how to run, how to cheat. So, like, where your hips need to be to run a better 40. It has nothing to do with football. How to maneuver your shoulders in such a way to get the absolute most out of your vertical and all stuff. So I think it's one of those things where after you do the combine, guys who didn't do that specialty training, guys are like, well, I'm a great football player, it'll show. Then go do the specialty training and ace their pro day.
Yeah, some track guys have some of the advantages over some things. Maybe not football players, but track guys. Rumors are saying that six, as high as six, NFL scouts attended Sam Darnold's workout. And all of them were from the Cleveland Browns.
Yes.
Why six scouts from the Browns?
And why was Jimmy Haslam, the owner of the Browns, sitting with Sam Darnold's parents in the stands? Why? At this point, just announce that you're taking Sam Darnold number one. That's, you know what? That's why. Because they don't have the guts to just say we're taking Sam Darnold. Sam Darnold is the number, like, Goodell should have popped up in the middle of the pro day while they were interviewing in the rain. They're interviewing Sam Darnold on ESPN. Well, how'd you feel he went? With the first pick of the 2018 NFL draft, the Cleveland Browns select Sam Darnold. All right, I'll see you guys later. I'll see you at the draft. Bye.
It's as simple as that. Not like the Giants like Sam Darnold and threw everything they can to say, no, hey, we're going to take him. We're here with mom and dad. Got everybody here. It's not a ploy to get the Giants to jump up,
I don't think you do. I don't think your owner goes for the ploy. And I don't. And when you're the top overall pick and you, what's the biggest knock on the Browns right now? Carson Wentz and Jared Goff. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You don't do that again. This is, you got rid of DeShone Kizer. You brought in a veteran to be your bridge quarterback. You're taking your quarterback in this draft, and it's Sam Darnold.
Three more here for you. Richard Sherman has to defend a deal he signed with the San Francisco 49ers. Why is he getting so defensive about this?
So everyone hates this deal. If everything's all said and done, he only gets a guarantee somewhere between $5 million.
$5 million, you're right.
Yeah, he's like a $3 million signing bonus and a $2 million roster bonus. So everybody's like, if you had an agent, you would have guaranteed $12 to $15 million. No problem. Why would you negotiate yourself a bad deal? Like, the Players Association is looking at this as, for all the great advances we just did with Kirk Cousins deals, your deal hurts us. Because your deal is legitimately a $5 million one-year deal.
And he believes in his mind that he didn't have guaranteed money before in Seattle coming off the injury. Okay, I get why you want your $5 million. Half of what he would have made years previous in Seattle, but he believes his incentives are good enough. He's banking on himself to be an all-pro level player.
And that's what he can do. I love that. But the only way that works is if the people you're negotiating with are as honest as you are.
And how did it happen? Like, why was he able, on, I think it was a Thursday, to sign up the 49ers before legal tampering started on a Monday? I get he technically didn't put pen to paper. But that whole thing of Richard Sherman signed with the 49ers, I was like, whoa, whoa. I thought we were waiting until Monday. What is, nobody else, that's so, you know, the whole thing was sketchy from the start, really. Felt like it, at least.
Is it because they released him? Did they release him, and is that why it worked? I don't know.
I don't know. Yeah,
it's that
unrestricted
whole,
versus restricted.
There's so much to it. There's so much to the way they do these things that make no sense.
We went long, but that's okay. I got two more for you. Yeah. Triple G, Gennady Golovkin calling Canelo Alvarez and Oscar De La Hoya dirty. Why is he doing that? This is over. I think the Mexican meat situation.
Because it makes it a little. If say you lose. Now you've got it. Well, I told you guys they cheated. And if you win, I beat them in spite of the fact they cheated. So it's just a little posturing.
If I was Triple G and going to take this fight for a second time, I don't know if I'd do it anymore.
Can we order steaks from there?
Can we do
from down in Mexico? Can you like instead of getting Omaha steaks, can we get like Mexican steroid steaks? Imagine how good we'd look on the field.
If they can let us pay for that in peso. What are you talking about? What field?
We're out there with the players, you know, when we're part of the empire.
You want us to order Mexican steaks.
Mexican steroid steaks. Woods is in. Do you want some of these Mexican steroid steaks or not? You wouldn't eat it? Dude,
no,
what better way to do steroids
not.
Than eat a steak?
I'm not doing that.
Come
no.
on.
By the way, Triple G.
It's almost like God went, I wish LeVac would do steroids. Let me put him in steak.
Don't take the fight, Triple G, and don't eat Mexican steaks. First of all, he should have won the fight, but Oscar De La Hoya is the promoter. It's a quote-unquote draw.
Are you racist against Mexican steaks?
I mean, I've never tried them before. Is that what you're telling me?
By your physique.
Moving on to the last one here.
I want Mexican steroid steaks.
Why? What are you talking about?
Why
it's
not?
Contaminated meat. It's not steroids.
Contaminated.
Yes, it is.
If I put vitamin in water, it's vitamin water. It's not contaminated water.
It's not how that works. Last one, LeVac.
Yeah, you can Google Mexican steaks. Just be careful. Just look at the screen, the preview shots, Woods. Just make sure it's not anything like a code for something.
LeVac, you and I have never been to Las Vegas.
Correct.
I passed on a chance to go to Las Vegas after my fiance said go on the trip to Las Vegas.
What?
Why would I do that?
You're stupid. No, you're trying to save money for a wedding. You're being responsible. You're being responsible.
Good.
You're saving money.
Very
for
respectable answers. Because most males.
Because I agree with you on that. Like that's. I've had opportunities to go, but I just financially was irresponsible in the past. Now I don't care.
Look at that. A very responsible and respectful answer by LeVac. I was ready to get crushed like everybody else has crushed me over the past month. And he can go ahead and crush me. Yeah, Tom Gons. TOMGOZZ. Passing on an opportunity to not only go to Vegas, but when the girl is telling you go because her relatives live out in Vegas, and maybe that's the whole key of everything.
She
that's,
can watch and see
yeah,
what you're
she's
doing.
Yeah, he's got bird eyes
she's
on me.
She's got spies.
But now I'm going to get 3 a.m. Snapchats from my buddies telling me how awesome it is. Although one friend has said that's not allowed. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
That was before the internet. Before everybody had the internet in their pocket. That's true. I kind of have one. I just need my... You have Netflix, right?
I do.
So there's a couple of us on the account. Each one's got a name. You know what I mean? Like... You go to the home screen so it doesn't mess with your favorites.
Yeah.
My kid has just informed me that she changed my name to Butt Munch on Netflix. Should I punish her? Should she be punished? Wood says it's funny. She wrote, I think I'm funny. Sent me a screenshot of the TV.
I think that's really funny. I'm also the person on my phone that thinks it's funny when my phone calls me Siri Seymour Butts, so I can't really defend her move.
But you know the worst part? She knows that I don't know how to change that name. I am stuck with that as my, so like if, like, let's say like, you know, hey, want to go to my place, watch a little Netflix and chill. Now it's, who's Bat Munch? That's me.
That's me.
What's not a place we can order Mexican steaks? Yes. We're going to be so swole. It's going to be awesome.
You're ordering that right now.
Okay. Oh, my credit card is
not going on that site. That does not.
Oh, that's
it's
a good
dot
point.
.com though. Wow,
that's a good point. Hey Woods, can we test your credit card? can we do this? Oh, you know what we'll do? We'll go to Price Chopper and get gift cards.
They have gift cards.
Maybe the company will pay for it.
It's a mortgage expense. It's a bit. We're doing this around the air.
Yeah,
this has nothing to do with me trying
expense.
To get swole.
That's
yeah.
right.
Yeah. This is
well, you got, you know, the day you guys throw tomatoes at me, we can grill up some steaks.
Just the one arm. Just a Mexican steak. Steroid arm. The tomatoes are sticking in the wall.
You need as many as you want, LeVac. That is not how
you wouldn't have one?
Absolutely not. That is not how he got
fine. I'll eat
jacked.
His too.
Then, like, see, Woods is gonna be able to catch him and throw him back at you then, because he'll have the Mexican stare. Like, it's like Popeye and spinach, right? You
no,
eat one of those.
Not. It's the most unsafe. Didn't you have somebody you worked with that had the milk in Mexico? Didn't that scare
yeah,
you off enough?
Yeah, I'm not going to drink milk in Mexico.
Oh, you're stinks.
I don't even
right.
think we're going to drink Corey's
like,
milk.
Who drinks warm milk anyway, anywhere?
I wouldn't even go drink Corey's milk. I won't even do that.
Oh, Gaz is dying to drink that.